talking about food webs. A food web shows all possible feeding relationships within a community. It consists of the sun, producers, and consumers. Producers make their own food and consumers eat other organisms. If one member of a food web is removed, an entire food web may collapse. Each organism represents a feeding level called a trophic level. The first feeding level is made of producers. The second feeding level is made of herbivores. The third level is made of consumers that eat other consumers. Behind me, we have the food web of a tropical rainforest. First, we will always start with the sun. The sun is our number one source of energy that will give off its energy to the trees or plants in general. Starting with a banana tree, a passion fruit tree, or a candy tree. With that, herbivores and omnivores will feed off of these three trees, which would be the three-tailed sloth, and cough, a capybara, a cricket, a spider, an ant, an iguana, or a bonobo. After that, a carnivore will eat the omnivores or the herbivores. A jaguar, a Bengal tiger, an emerald boa, and a poison dart frog will eat these. The poison dart frog will go for the spider, the ant, and the cricket. The Bengal tiger will eat either the iguana, a bonobo, a macaw, or a three-toed sloth, along with the jaguar. The jaguar will also eat those too. An emerald boa will eat an iguana, or a macaw, or a capybara, depending on if it's capable. Moving on to the spiders and ants, they will feed off of each other or the cricket, and they will also go for the plants. And the omnivores will just go for both plants, and if they have to, they will go for the other meat that is near. With that in mind, we will now talk about an energy pyramid and how energy is passed through it. In an energy pyramid, there are four levels. The bottom is made up of primary producers, the second level is made up of primary consumers, the third level is made up of secondary consumers, the fourth level is made up of tertiary consumers. On the first level of the pyramid, there is the most energy, which is 6,000. On the second, there is 600. The third has 60. The fourth has only 6. If you notice the pattern, we're dividing by 10 each time. The energy pyramid shows what energy each level uses and what the next level gets from consuming it. Behind me is an energy pyramid. As said, on the bottom, there consists of 6,000. And that's when the sun gives the energy to the trees, or plants, or flowers. It then goes to the second level, which has 600. And that is when an herbivore and an omnivore eats off of the tree or any plant. They get the energy that was left over from what it used. It then goes to 60, which then the omnivores will get from consuming the herbivores or the other omnivores from eating from what they had used and what was now left over. Going on from the third level, it goes to the final level, which is the fourth. It consists of 6. This is where the carnivores will eat the omnivores, and they get the energy that is left over from what the omnivores haven't been able to use.